Addictions have a profound impact on not just the individuals falling prey to them, but also on their families and the rest of the society. Many of the reasons behind crime, big and small, fall on the shoulders of drug and alcohol abuse. It is responsible for tens of thousands of deaths and injuries across the country. Child abuse and domestic violence are often directly related to alcohol or drug abuse among the perpetrators. Addictions can also quickly drain a person's finances and cause them to end up on the streets. If only we could create an addiction-free world. That, ladies and gentlemen, is the vision that propels our next speaker, Mukta Kuntambikar, director of Muktangan, reckoned among the country's finest institutes in the field of drugs and alcohol de-addiction. A seed that was planted by Mukta's mother has, under Mukta's able leadership, grown into a larger, more structured, scientific and professional center, known for its contemporary and innovative approaches in helping addicts and their families reclaim their lives from the dark throes of despair, helplessness and stigma. Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together for Mukta Kuntambikar.
Good afternoon. Thank you very much for inviting me here today. As it was told in my introduction, I work in Muktangan Rehabilitation Center. Muktangan is a treatment center for addiction. My father, Dr. Anil Outsert, who is the founder of Muktangan, he always says, miracle is an everyday affair in Muktangan. I know nobody believes in miracle these days. But when I tell you the stories about Muktangan, I am sure all of you will start believing in miracles. First, I am going to tell you a story about Rahul. Rahul Jadhav. Rahul was admitted in Muktangan in 2015. Rahul is from Mumbai, from a middle class family. And in his college days, he got involved in addiction and also in crime. For so many years, he was a part of the infamous Mumbai underworld gang. Finally, Rahul was arrested. He was in jail for 4 years. And after releasing from jail, Rahul did not want to start his criminal activities again. So he decided to stay with his family and look for a job. But because of his background, it was very difficult for Rahul to get a job. Finally, he got a job at one small place where he did not tell about his past. But one day, there was some crime in that area and the police came looking for Rahul at his workplace. And because of that, Rahul lost that job also. Again, it was getting very difficult for him to get a new job. He was getting frustrated. His anger, frustration and his addiction was increasing. He was demanding money from his family. So he was a nuisance to his family and his neighbors. His father came to know about Muktangan and he admitted Rahul with us. When Rahul completed his 1 month treatment, we realized that just 1 month of the treatment is not enough for Rahul. So we convinced him to stay for a few more months. And at the end of the treatment, Rahul knew that he will not get any job in Mumbai. So he requested us to give some job in Muktangan. So Rahul started working in our housekeeping department and this work really changed him. Rahul always says, when I started cleaning the toilets, I was able to clean my mind. And then Rahul came to know about one marathon event in Pune and he wanted to take part in that. So he came to me and that time he told me, I am a very fast runner because in my criminal days, I used to run so fast that police was not able to catch me. So my husband Ashish, who is a marathoner, who provided all the guidance to Rahul, and then Rahul started running. His first event was 10 kilometers. Then step by step, he started running half marathon of 21 kilometers, and then full marathon, 42 kilometers. Rahul wanted to take part in Mumbai Marathon. That was actually his dream. So in January 2017, Rahul completed the full marathon, a famous Mumbai marathon. And when he got that medal, he was very happy. He went to the police station next day, he took that medal with him, he showed all his photographs. Till that time, the police were not ready to believe that Rahul is a changed person. But when they saw that, those photos and the medal, they finally believed in him. And that whole police station gave a standing ovation to Rahul. This is Rahul's photograph in the marathon event. And now Rahul works in Mumbai. He works in the chocolate factory. That is his employer, Mr. Morde. He knows about Rahul's, all these criminal background, about his addiction, but he supports all Rahul's running activity. And this year, in January, on 26 January, as a tribute to Muktangan, Rahul ran all the way from Mumbai to Pune. He came to Muktangan running all the way from Mumbai. And I'm very glad today Rahul is here with me, if you can stand up. And I'm very, very proud of Rahul. Actually, last week, he went running from Mumbai to Ratnagiri. 300 odd kilometers he ran in, he completed it in 6 days. So he's always running now. Running is his positive addiction now. So like Rahul, we have thousands of stories in Muktangan which make you believe in miracles. So how this all started? It was started by my parents, Dr. Anita Ausat and Dr. Anil Ausat. My mother was working as a psychiatrist. And around year 1982, drug addiction came to India for the first time. It was heroin. In India, they don't call it heroin. It is called as brown sugar, because heroin is it's in the adulterated form. And that time, there was no treatment facility in Maharashtra. And this addiction came as an epidemic. So many youngsters got involved into that. And my mother's friend's son, he was staying in one hostel, and he got involved into drug addiction. So this friend got this boy to my parents, and my parents treated this boy at our residence. And while talking with this boy every day, my father realized that addiction is not just a personal problem, but this is a big social problem. So he did a lot of research, and then he wrote a series of articles in the newspapers. After reading those articles, many people started approaching my parents because their children were involved in addiction. But it was not possible for my parents to treat all these boys at our residence. They were also approached by famous, this is a photo of my parents. They were also approached by famous Marathi writer, Pu L Deshpande, who was very restless to know that there is no treatment facility in Maharashtra. So he offered financial help to start a rehabilitation center. So this is a photo of Pu L and his wife Sunita Bhai. So with the financial help of Pu L Deshpande, Muktangan was started on 29th August 1986. And this is our first patient. His name is Mahadev Ghare. On the day of inauguration, he was admitted. In this August, Muktangan will be completing 32 years. And Mahadev Ghare will also complete 32 years of his sobriety. My mother used to call him our lucky patient because he gave us a very good start. He is not educated, but he is the role model of thousands of people who came to us for admission. My mother had not seen any rehabilitation center. So my parents did not know what to do, what kind of treatment we can have. So they decided to learn from the patients. My mother always used to say, whenever our, she used to call them friends, not patients, whenever our friends will start coming, we'll ask them what kind of treatment they require. And she started discussing with them about their expectation. And in this way, Muktangan treatment program, it's not a ready-made treatment program, but it is evolved by learning from our patient friends. So this program is based on Indian culture. In Indian culture, we give a lot of importance to family. So we try to involve the family members in the treatment. We have a lot of support group activities, family counseling activities for them. All our therapies are based on Indian culture. We have yoga, meditation, we have pranayama, lots of art-based therapies. So you can see a photo of music therapy. We try to make use of Indian classical music as a part of therapy. We also have Zen masters who come regularly to teach mindfulness meditation. And this really helps them. My mother's family background is of freedom fighters. So she knew that if you want to achieve freedom from anything, there is one man whose principles you should follow, Mahatma Gandhi. So Muktangans, in all the therapies, we use Gandhian principles. People think ambience of a rehabilitation center, it will be either like a hospital or like jail. But ambience of Muktangan is like ashram of Mahatma Gandhi, where everybody stay together. They help each other. They wear white clothes. We don't have any special room for them. They take part in all the activities of Muktangan, right from the cleaning their ward to helping in the kitchen. Everything is done by them. And this really helps them to change. They have to follow a strict discipline. And this is very, very important for them. These are some photos of our center. So this kind of setup we have. And then, I started working in Muktangan 25 years back, after I completed my master's in clinical psychology. And after that, before joining my PhD program, I wanted to do 1 month internship. So I started going to Muktangan. And that was actually a turning point in my life, because I started the way how a mother talks to the patient. And it was not like a doctor talking to the patient, but a mother talking to her child. So I was quite impressed by that. And then I decided to continue working in Muktangan. And I'm very happy about this decision, because my mother was diagnosed with cancer. And I got 4 years to learn from her, to work with her. And when she passed away, I started a support group in her memory. This is a support group for women having addiction in the family. Whenever there is addiction in family, it is the woman in the family, they have to suffer the most. Because the person in addiction, he expresses all his anger, aggression towards these women. Other family members blame women for the addiction in the family. So they have guilty feeling, they are depressed, lot of stress is there. So we started this support group. And this is my usual experience. Whenever a woman comes to me for counseling, she's sitting in front of me, she's crying, she doesn't have any hope. So I just suggest her to attend the support group meeting. When she enters that room, that entering in that room itself changes her outlook, because she can see there are so many other women sitting there. So till that time, she is thinking, I am the only one in this world who is having addiction in the family. But she realizes that there are so many other women along with me. So she feels little better. She starts opening out with them. And this opening out helps to come out of her negative emotions. And I have so many strong women now working with me. And we have branches of Sahachari, not only in Pune, but all the major cities of Maharashtra. After starting this support group, one day one woman came to me. And she told me, you're asking us to be strong. But how can we be strong if we are not financially independent? So that gave us idea to start some vocational rehabilitation activity for them. So we started a catering activity. We started this with just 2 women, and now this is a big activity. We have started a company for them, and I'm very proud to say that this company is not dependent upon charity, but they make their own profits. I'm talking only about men patients. You must be wondering about what happens to women who are having addiction problem. When I started working 25 years back, we had one internship student who was from some other country. And that time he asked me a question, I can see all men patients, what about women? So that time I was surprised. I told him, we don't have problem of woman addiction in India. But the situation started changing, I think after the year 2000 or so. Many women started coming to us for the treatment. So we had, in 2009, we started this separate center for women. It is called as Nishigan. So now in Muktangan, we work, these are